Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Gene, its nature, expression and regulation. And in that, today we are studying topic transcription. Now when I say transcription, it means the process to form mRNA or messenger RNA. Let's study about it today. Transcription. When I say that word transcription, in English, if you all just try and find out the meaning of it, it means to read on or to find on. Now, during the process of transcription, what happens is mRNA is formed, or you can say messenger RNA is formed. And this messenger RNA basically will have information in the form of genes for the process of protein synthesis. Now, how does this mRNA is formed? Where does it is formed? There is a stretch of DNA present, and this stretch of DNA is formed after RNA splicing, that is introns and exon splicing. The stretch of DNA on which mRNA is formed is called as transcription unit, and this whole process is also termed as transcription. So how does this stretch of DNA basically looks like? It consists of three regions. The first region is the promoter region. The second region is the structural gene region, and the third region is the terminator region, or the process or the part where termination or mRNA synthesis stops. The process actually starts by binding of RNA polymerase on the promoter region. Now, once RNA polymerase binds on the promoter region, it reads the nucleotide sequence on the promoter region. And we all know that the difference between RNA and DNA is only of uracil. Rest all nucleotides are the same. So RNA polymerase starts adding the nucleotides in RNA fashion, and once nucleotides are added, the process of adding nucleotides stops once RNA polymerase reaches the termination sequence or the end sequence. And this is how the process of mRNA synthesis is stopped. Now this mRNA or the messenger RNA will further go and form your protein, that is, it will be used in the translation process. So the process actually was starting from replication, that is, your DNA is formed, then your transcription takes place, that is, mRNA is formed, and finally your translation or the protein is formed. Transcription. Now, transcription is a process to form mRNA or messenger RNA, the RNA which will have information just to make your proteins inside your body. Does transcription process take place in eukaryotes? Yes, it does. Even in prokaryotes, in certain forms, it takes place. The stretch of the DNA, or you can say the part of the DNA which gets transcribed, or you can say the messages from which are coded or copied in simple language, you can say, to form RNA or messenger RNA is termed as transcription unit or transcription segment. Now there are three different regions which are present on transcription unit. First one is promoter region, second one is the structural gene region, and the third one is the termination region or the end region. The region where transcription begin and promoter bind to RNA polymerase is the promoter region. Students, this is a diagram of transcription process. Now, what does happens in transcription process, in simple language, if I could say, is this is a stretch of DNA on which your messenger RNA or your mRNA would be formed. Now, this mRNA would have the promoter region, the operator region, and the structural gene. Or you can say in simple language, the terminator region and the structural gene region. Now, this region or the starting part is the operator region. The middle part would be the structural gene region, and the ending part is the terminator region, which helps to form the mRNA or the messenger RNA. Once mRNA is formed, we all know that mRNA is single-stranded. Now, inside the double-stranded DNA, the DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid has to be unwinded to form single-stranded mRNA or messenger RNA. Once single-stranded mRNA or messenger RNA is formed, this mRNA will move outside of nucleus, because DNA was present inside nucleus, to cytoplasm. And this mRNA or messenger RNA has exposed nucleotide bases. Now, we all know that RNA is single-stranded, so it has exposed nucleotide bases. And due to its exposed nucleotide bases, it will further undergo the process of translation and then form protein. So, from this journey from nucleus to its journey to cytoplasm and then protein, this is how mRNA goes on. So we can say that the process of replication takes place inside nucleus, whereas the process of transcription will take place inside the cytoplasm or the jelly-like substance inside the cell. RNA polymerase is present inside human beings as well as different animals wherever transcription is needed. Students, today what we studied was about transcription. In simple language, if I had to say what was transcription, I could say that transcription is nothing but copying DNA into single-stranded RNA. A question would arise in everyone's mouth out here, that why DNA cannot itself synthesize the protein or itself serve as a messenger? Why there's an involvement of mRNA? What's the need? Why to invest in ATP or in energy? The answer to this is, students, that DNA has to undergo replication process. It has to look after all our genetic makeup and all our genetic factors, especially our traits, our characteristics. So in all this work, it will not get time to form proteins. That's the reason DNA always tries to make mRNA and transfer its characteristics on mRNA. And this mRNA further will form protein by the process of translation. That is the reason. Do proteins like insulin, epinephrine, non-epinephrine, all this are formed by the process of transcription, or the messages are present on mRNA? Yes. All these proteins in human beings were formed with the help of transcription, that is mRNA, and further proteins were formed during the process of protein synthesis. I hope, students, you all are clear about this concept of transcription. Thank you.